Morning, today I'm gonna talk about the development of a standard test phantom for magnetic resonance guided high intensity focused ultrasound. As the word suggests, MR guided HIFU is the combination of magnetic resonance imaging and high intensity focused ultrasound for thermal ablation of unwanted tissue. An HIFU transducer delivers a high level of ultrasound intensities to increase the temperature into the tissue. When the temperature exceeds 56 degrees for 1 second, there is irreversible damage of the tissue. Magnetic resonance imaging is used for targeting the region of interest, for monitoring the temperature in real time, and for assessing treatment effectiveness. St. Thomas Hospital, we have S. Phillips on a leaf, which is marked for treatment of bone metastasis and uterine fibroids. As you can see, the patient is positioned into the MRI scanner, and an anatomical image is taken for treatment planning. The HIFU transducer delivers high-intensity focus ultrasound, while the MRI thermometry allows real-time monitoring of the temperature rise. Later on, you can take another image to assess the treatment effectiveness. So, why do we need the test object? The use of HIFU is becoming widespread, and there is the need to standardize the way in which the therapies are described and reported. The main ultrasound field parameters, such as local pressure or local intensities, are well described in water. However, there is the need to define parameters for describing the interaction of the ultrasound fields in the medium. In other words, we need dose quantities, something equivalent to the absorbed dose or the equivalent dose that is used in ionizing radiation. For thermal ablation therapy, we need a simple device that allows the quantification of temperature rise induced by an HIFU source in a reference material. This can be useful for many applications, such as the assessment of performance of existing device, definition of QA and calibration protocols, optimization of procedures, and comparison of results across the centers. When you want to build the phantom, the first problem you have is the choice of materials. Materials have to be compatible with the technology of interest, which in this case are ultrasound and magnetic resonance imaging. We use the well-known IC recipe, which is an agar-based TMM and a speed of sound 1540 meters per second and attenuation 0.5 dB per centimeter. We use 3D printed bone equivalent disc to mimic flat bone and type T copper Constanta thermocouple of size 75 micron to be MRI compatible and to minimize interaction with ultrasound fields. Thermocouples were placed in the region below the bone and above the bone, and one thermocouple was used as reference. Positioning tools and engravings were manufactured for supporting thermocouple identification in the 3D space in magnetic resonance imaging. Here you can see the setup of the phantom on the sonar leaf. This is the HIFU table, this is the phantom, this is the MRI call. The HIFU transducer is placed below the phantom. This is a screenshot of the sonar leaf console, so you can see coronal, transverse and sagittal view of the phantom and monitoring of the near field. You can see the positioning tools and how they help into identification of the thermocouple, and you can see the 3D printed bone. What you do is simply to place a cell in a region of interest, you select the power, press a button, and the sonication will start. MRI thermometry allows the temperature monitoring in real time, and the console will tell you information about the power and the length of the exposure. This looks like quite a good system, a cool system, however, it's quite limited in spatial resolution and temporal resolution. In order to assess the reproducibility of the machine, we did three experiments in two different days with two different settings, bone metastasis and uterine fibroids. The table shows absolute temperature rise, while in clinical practice, you need to think that you start from a temperature of about 37 degrees of the human body. Thermocouples shows a variability between 10 and 50%, MRI thermometry shows a variability between 10 and 30%. Percentage difference between thermocouple and MRI thermometry was between 10 and 22%. These are simple plots that show the temperature rise as function of the power. Obviously, exposure in bone, the temperature is quite high, so you lose a bit of linearity in terms of temperature dependency. If you think that these errors are quite big, actually they are not, because there are many sources of error across the experiment. These errors are both random and systematic. In particular, there is the ability to target a 75 micron junction of the thermocouple, and there is the viscous heating artifact. The viscosizing artifact is due to the interaction between the ultrasound fields and the thermocouple. This error has been minimized by choosing a small thermocouple that is 75 micron, as is about 5% of the wavelength of the beam, and using the second derivative method, which has been described by Morris et al. So in conclusion, we achieved our goal. We developed the test object, which is a working prototype and allows temperature quantification in a reference material. Main limitation of the study are for sure the number of experiments, which are just 3. However, you need to deal with the clinical schedule of the machine and the cost, which is about £500 per hour, although I'm a hospital staff. In addition, we had COVID-19. We are a K hospital, so the research activity was completely stopped. It would be also nice to collect and compare data with different scanners and add to the phantom motion and perfusion, which can further challenge the machine. Finally, thermocouple provide measurement in a single point, and this is a major limitation. However, we are already moving forward, and we got a grant to develop a thin film matrix array sensor for temperature distribution measurements. In addition, we have a paper under review in ultrasound in medicine and biology for the development of a PVA-based thermochromic material. So this material changes color in relation to temperature in the region of interest of IFU. And this material is quite interesting because it can be embedded in phantoms or in 3D models. I would like to thank my team, and I'm happy now to take your questions.